Facing my grandma's coffin, I felt a strange sense of peace. Grandma passed away peacefully in the night with nothing but a mild flu and cough, a much better way to pass than many other violent deaths. My relatives and I said our final goodbyes and let the workers take over. Grandma had lived her life to the fullest. She had traveled around the world, experienced multiple cultures across the globe. She even went trekking through the Amazon rainforest last month. Good for Grandma. But I will still miss her. All of us will. She had inspired us to do great things. She was the literal beam of light in our darkest moments. As the workers were taking her away, a tiny TV flashed with the words breaking news. Interested, I edged closer to hear it better. A reporter with a crisp suit is in the middle of the story.
The symptoms can be passed for pollen fever, but in reality, it is more dangerous and deadly than portrayed. Scientists have reason to believe that the fungi originated from Brazil, branching off of a strain of fungi called Ohippiocordyceps, where it enslaves the ant to do its bidding. It has now evolved to enslave humans in a similar manner, by slowly lowering the host's metabolic rate to levels so low that they would be pronounced dead. Then, the fungi will wait for the host's burial, on which they will sense and will sprout out from the host and release its spores into the atmosphere. But if the host is somehow not buried after the slow metabolic state, or when the fungi senses extreme danger facing the host, the fungi will instantly awaken the host and give it full conscious.
A blood-curdling scream cut through the news report. All of us snapped our heads in the direction of the scream and realized where it came from. From inside the crematorium.